Can anyone unmute yourself and let me know that whether my slides are visible or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Good afternoon to everyone. So, if you remember when I was discussing this scale part, I have given you the introduction part of the scale, that what is a scale and why we use this scale in engineering drawing. We have discussed one term called representative fraction. That is nothing but the ratio of dimensions of the drawing divided by dimensions of the object. Now that dimension can be length, it can be area, it can be volume. Accordingly, the expression or the formula for RF will change. So whenever you are solving a problem based on scale, firstly you have to find out that which formula of RF is applicable for that problem. Accordingly, you have to use the correct formula and you have to get the value of RF. If you remember last time when I was discussing this RF, I have told you that we can classify scale on the basis of RF into three types, and those three types are enlarging scale, reducing scale and full size scale. I repeat, on the basis of RF we can classify scales as enlarging scale, reducing scale and full size scale. So this was the discussion which I discussed with you all in the class when I was discussing this scale part. So the next part, in order to draw any kind of scale, the first part is you have to determine the value of RF, that is representative factor. The second part is you have to determine length of the scale, because if you are drawing a scale, you should know with that scale, or what is the length of your scale? What is the length of your scale? So length of the scale is calculated by the formula RF into maximum length to be measured. RF already you can calculate by the help of this formula into, you have to multiply that RF with the maximum length to be measured. For example, I am having a scale of say 30 centimeter. In that 30 centimeter scale, maximum distance, how much I can measure? I can measure maximum a distance of 30 centimeter. So that 30 centimeter is nothing but my maximum length to be measured. So this value of maximum length will be given to you in the problem in indirect manner. You have to read the problem carefully. You have to identify what is the value of maximum length. Then multiply that maximum length with the RF value which you have calculated in the very first step. You will get the length of the scale. Now with this length of
sir,
the... Yes?
Sir, can you add my friend Tujo? He has been trying for the last 10 minutes. Can you please check it and add him? He has been trying since 2:10.
Oh, but if I do like this, then how I will take the class? He should join
yes,
in
sir.
Time
yes,
if
I
he's...
Understand.
If he is not joining in time, that is not my fault. No. Okay. So please tell all of your friend. Now I will not allow anybody to join. Okay. Otherwise, we won't be able to complete. I am making them join. Two peoples.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Okay. Please tell your friends that no more joining is allowed. Fine.
Okay.
Is my slide visible? Is my slide visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what I was talking, that once you get the maximum length to be measured, you have to multiply that maximum length which you can measure with the scale which you are drawing with RF value. RF value already you have calculated from the very first step. Once you multiply this maximum length with the RF value, you will get the length of the scale. Now the very first step is what? Very first step is with the help of your pencil, with the help of your pencil and scale, you have to draw this length of scale in your drawing sheet. So the very first step is calculation of RF. Formulas are given. So you have to read the problem carefully. Accordingly, you have to see that which formula is applicable for me to solve this problem. You have to use that particular formula. And once you have got the value of RF, the second step is you have to determine the length of the scale. And that is given by RF into maximum length. What is maximum length? Maximum length is that possible length which you can measure by the scale which you are going to draw in your drawing sheet. The scale which you are going to draw in your drawing sheet, in that scale, how much maximum length you can measure, that is your maximum length. Multiply that length with the RF value, you will get the length of the scale. Any doubt in these two steps? Hello? Any doubt in these two steps? So you have to do this calculation part by your pencil. I repeat, you have to do this calculation part by your pencil, that too in bold capital letters, maintaining the proper lettering and numbering concept. You have to do this calculation in bold capital letters. Cursive is not allowed. And don't use pen. You have to use pencil. Okay. So, if you see the formula for RF, it is dimension of drawing divided by dimension of object. Now, there may be the case that dimension of drawing is in, say, centimeter. Dimension of object is in meter. Fine. In that case, you cannot get the value of RF, because in numerator, you are having the dimension in centimeter. In denominator, that same dimension is in meter. Then what you need to do, you have to convert either the numerator part, which is in centimeter, into meter, or the denominator part, which is in meter, into centimeter. Once you match both the units of numerator and denominator, then you can calculate the value of RF. So in order to convert one unit into other unit, you should know these conversions. 1 kilometer equal to 10 hectometer, 1 hectometer 10 decameter, 1 decameter equals 10 meters, 1 meter equals 10 decimeter, and 1 decimeter equals 10 centimeter, 1 centimeter equals 10 millimeters. Dimension of the drawing can be in any of these units. Dimension of the object can be in any of these units. Area of the drawing can be any of these units. Area of the object can be any of these units. You have to make either numerator, you have to match the unit of numerator with the denominator, or you have to match the unit of denominator with the numerator. Then only you will proceed for the calculation part of RF. Is it clear? Any doubt so far? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay. So, one type of classification of scale is on the basis of RF value. That is enlarging, reducing, and full size scale. We can also classify that same scale in general category. If I want to classify a scale, I can classify scales again into several type. The very first type is plane scale. Plane scale. What is a plane scale? Plane scale is an instrument by which we can measure dimensions up to single decimal places. For example, 4.4 centimeter, 5.5 kilometer, 7.2 decimeter, 7.2 meter. All these things we can measure by the help of plane scale. Second type of classification is your diagonal scale. And this is what we have to do it in our first lab assignment, first question. Diagonal scale. What is diagonal scale? Diagonal scale is an instrument used for measuring dimensions up to 2 decimal places. For example, 4.42 centimeter. You can use diagonal scale, but you cannot use plane scale. 5.65 kilometer. For that, you have to use diagonal scale. You cannot use plane scale. Is the difference clear? Difference between plane scale and diagonal scale?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If the difference is clear, sir, then you tell me, I'm asking you one question. We all have seen the scale, which we normally use in our day-to-day life. So that scale is an example of plane scale or a diagonal scale. The scale which we are having in our
plane scale.
Yes, because if you see the divisions of the plane scale, those divisions are up to single decimal places. We can measure 4.4 centimeter. We can measure 4.6 centimeter, but I cannot measure 4.62 centimeter. So remember one thing, that the scale which we use in our day-to-day life, that is an example of plane scale. Okay. So this was about plane scale and diagonal scale. The third type of classification is vernier scale. It is also a measuring instrument used for measuring dimensions up to 2 decimal places. Diagonal scale also we can measure up to 2 decimal places. Vernier scale also we can measure up to 2 decimal places. Then what is the difference between diagonal scale and vernier scale? If you can tell.
Sir, with the vernier scale, we can measure the like the circular object's dimension.
Circular object dimension, such as cylinder.
Sir, are you meaning about the vernier caliper?
Sir, just like the
vernier caliper is nothing but a vernier scale only. See,
sir, diameter of wires.
My question is, diagonal scale also I can measure up to 2 decimal places. With vernier scale also I can measure up to 2 decimal places. Then why 2 different scales are there? Then with the diagonal scale only, means then diagonal scale only can serve the purpose of vernier scale. Why there is a name vernier scale is given?
Sir, height as well as the breadth of a cuboid, for that one we can use vernier scale. We can't use that as normal diagonal scale.
Height is 12.25 centimeter. Width is 12.46 centimeter. 2 decimal places.
Just like, sir, for the circular object, just like the bob, means in a pendulum we have the bob, so we can measure the dimensions of that with the vernier scale only.
Okay. That is partly correct. Okay, I'm telling you why we use 2 different scales. Remember, by vernier scale, you can measure very small dimensions up to 2 decimal places, such as 0.02 centimeter, 0.01 millimeter, 0.01 decimeter. But diagonal scales are used for measuring dimensions, you want to measure a distance of 14.24 kilometer, then you have to go for diagonal scale. But if I say you that measure 0.02 kilometer distance, then you have to go for vernier scale. This is the basic difference between diagonal scale and vernier scale. And then whatever you are telling that for circular object, if we want to measure the internal diameter, we use vernier scale. That is the secondary concept. The primary concept is, for small measurements up to 2 decimal places, I go for vernier scale. For large measurements or for big measurements up to 2 decimal places, I go for diagonal scale. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So, next category of scale is your comparative scale. What is a comparative scale? It is a scale which can be used for comparing 2 different units. Is it clear? For example, if I want to differentiate meter from centimeter, I will use a scale. That scale is called comparative scale. if I want to measure, if I want to differentiate millimeter with decimeter, again I will use one scale. That scale is known as my comparative scale. So if this is my comparative scale, you just let me know that the normal scale which we use in our day-to-day life, whether it is a comparative scale, yes or no.
Sir, the steel one is a comparative scale.
Whatever we, whether it is steel or whether it is plastic.
I don't know about the plastic.
The normal scale which we use every day. That is an example of a comparative scale, yes or no. Hello. Answer, please answer. It can be wrong.
Yes, sir, yes. Means you are telling about the scales which you use in that, like the engineering drawings and all about that.
Mere bhai, aapke paas ek geometry box hai. Uske us box ke andar scale hai. Us scale ke baare mein puch raha hu main. Whether that scale is a comparative scale or not.
The normal scales we use.
Yes, that same scale which you go and buy from the shop. Is it a comparative scale? That is an example of a comparative scale. How?
One side is inch and one side is inch.
Very good. If you see, this is your 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, likewise 15, 30. So this is in centimeter. But if you see the bottom part, this is 0, this is 1, 2, 3. These are in inches. These are in inches and these are in centimeter. That means in a single instrument, you can compare centimeter with inch. So it is an example of comparative scale. That means the normal scale which we use daily, that is an example of a plane scale also, and that is an example of a comparative scale also. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So just wait, let me erase these things. Okay. And the last classification of scale is the scale of chords. Scale of chords. It is a type of scale which is used for measuring or constructing angles. So tell me which instrument is, I will call in my geometry box as a scale of chord.
Protector?
Yes, very good. Protector is an example of scale of chord, because with protector I can measure distances, but I can measure what? I can measure distances in terms of angles. 30 degree, 40 degree. If I want to draw a 50 degree line, I will use protector. I won't use normal scale. If I want to draw a 60 degree line, I have to use protector. So those type of measurement I have to do with a scale called scale of chords. And very best common example is your protector. Is it clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So this was all about the scales. Fine. Now we will solve one problem. Since in our syllabus only diagonal scale part is there, so we will go for the diagonal scale problem. And let me tell you, in the diagonal scale problem only, you will see that I can solve the plane scale part also. That means by using diagonal scale, you can solve the plane scale part. But by using plane scale, you cannot solve the diagonal scale problem. That you will come to know within few minutes. Okay. So let me go back to that problem. Remember, I am not solving the same problem which is given in your assignment, but similar type of problem I am solving. You should know the concept that how we are solving the problem. Fine. Let us read the problem. The problem is the distance between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. I repeat, the distance between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometers. In a railway map, it is represented by a line of 5 centimeter long. Find its RF. Draw a diagonal scale to show single kilometer and maximum 600 kilometer. Indicate on that scale following distances: 222 kilometer, 336 kilometer, 459 kilometer, 569 kilometer. Okay, so this is a problem of diagonal scale. But in this problem, if I remove this word or if I erase this word called diagonal, then how you will understand that this is a problem of diagonal scale? Please tell me how you will understand that this is a problem of diagonal scale if I remove that word called diagonal. How you will understand? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
I am telling you that if I remove that word called diagonal, draw a diagonal scale, if I erase that word called diagonal, then remaining problem is same. Then how you will understand that this is a problem of diagonal scale? That is my question.
So then here there are options like 222, 336 kilometer. We have to divide it with the RF, so we will get a decimal point something. So to measure that distance, we need diagonal scale.
Okay, fine. That is also one way. Another way is, if you see these distances, the scale which you want to draw, on that scale you have to mark these distances. Let us assume I want to mark 336 kilometer. How I can mark? I have to divide this 336 kilometer. How I can divide? 336 is nothing but 300 plus 30 plus 6. So you can see that if this problem was a problem of plane scale, with the help of plane scale you can measure this much distance, that is 330 kilometer. But this 6 kilometer you cannot measure by the help of plane scale. Because this is, if you see this problem, these are all 2 decimal places. These values are all 2 decimal places values. Yes or no? Hello.
Sir, how? It is an integer.
See, if I am having this scale, this is a normal scale. Say this is 0 kilometer. This is 100 kilometer, this is 200 kilometer, this is 300 kilometer, this is 400 kilometer. 100, 200, 300, 400. Fine. So if you have seen your normal scale, in between 1 and 2, what is there? 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. Similarly, in between 100 and 200, if I divide this kilometer, this 100 kilometer into 10 equal parts, this will be 110 kilometer, 120 kilometer, 130 kilometer, 140 kilometer, and so on. Now, can I say that I can measure 300 plus 30 on my normal scale? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I can measure. It is a plane scale. But where is this 6? Can you measure this 6? Can you measure this 6? I cannot measure this 6. Fine. So by looking at these values and by plotting in a plane scale, I came to understand that this is a problem of diagonal scale. This is not a problem of plane scale, because in plane scale I am not getting that second decimal value, and in this problem that second decimal value is, for this particular portion, is 6. That 6, how I will get, where I will get, I don't know. So this is a problem of diagonal scale. Likewise, you have to understand that whether it is a problem of diagonal scale or it is a problem of plane scale, because in your exam also I will not write in the question that draw a diagonal scale. You have to read the question and you have to identify which scale you have to draw. I hope I have made myself clear. Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Sir.
Okay. So, fine. Let me erase these things first. Okay. So, the very first step in order to draw a diagonal scale is the calculation of RF. I know that RF is what? Dimension of the drawing. That is dimension of, this is your dimension of drawing divided by dimension of object. So read the problem and then tell me what is your dimension of drawing and what is your dimension of object. Please tell me.
So the dimension of drawing is 5 centimeters and that of object is 200 kilometers.
Yes, see. My aim is to measure a distance between Delhi and Agra. And that distance is 200 kilometers. There is no scale in the world by which we can measure a distance of 200 kilometers. Fine. You are having that normal scale which you use in your day-to-day life. With the help of that scale, you have to measure this distance 200 kilometers. It is impossible to measure. You can measure it. It will take many time, it will take some time, it may take 10 days, 15 days, 20 days, I don't know, fine. But this same 200 kilometer line can be represented by some centimeter line or some meter line in my drawing sheet, because I have already studied what is enlarging scale, what is reducing scale by the help of RF. So if you read this problem, it is given that the distance between Delhi and Agra is 200 kilometer. My object is what? My object is, I want to measure distance between two fixed points, and that is 200 kilometers. So, dimension of object given is 200 kilometers. In a railway map, that same distance is measured by, is represented by a line of 5 centimeter long. That means you are drawing a 200 kilometer line by a 5 centimeter line in your drawing sheet. That means dimension of your drawing is nothing but 5 centimeter. Is it clear? How I came to know
yes,
that?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Fine. So this you have to understand by reading the problem. Directly it won't be given to you. Okay. So now can I solve this RF? Can I get solve this RF? I cannot solve. Why? Because if you see the top part is in centimeter, the bottom part is in kilometer. Either you convert centimeter into kilometer or you convert kilometer into centimeter. Just do it and tell me what is RF. And remember one more thing, whenever you are representing RF, either you have to represent RF in terms of 1 is to something or in terms of something is to 1. Because 1 is to something will be enlarging scale reducing, because 1 is your dimension of the drawing. That something is your dimension of the object. That means you are reducing the dimension of your original object. So this will be your reducing scale. And this is something is to 1. Means this is your dimension of drawing. This is your dimension of object. So here what you are doing? You are enlarging the dimension of object. So this will be your enlarging scale. So just solve it. And just tell me what is the value of RF. Either it is 1 is to something or it is something is to 1. Just tell me. Calculate.
Sir, 1 is to 4 to the power 4 into 10 to the power 6.
That means 1 divided by 40 lakh or 1 is to 40 lakh,
yeah.
Right? Baki log, whether you are getting the same value or not.
Sir, 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 7.
You cannot represent RF in decimals. I have told you in the last class. Whatever one person just now told, that 1 is to something or something is to 1, and that something should be a whole number, it cannot be in decimal. So please tell me. Please solve and let me know whether you are getting 1 is to 40 lakh or not.
Yes, sir. 1 is to 40 lakh, yeah.
Okay. Yes. That will be the correct answer, I hope. Let me see. Yes, you are getting the value of RF as 1 is to 40 lakh. You got the value of RF. Next is, you need to get the length of the scale. Then only you can draw that length. So length of the scale is what? It is RF into maximum length. It is RF into maximum length. RF is 1 divided by 40 lakh into what is the maximum length? Just identify from the problem. Just identify from the problem that what is the maximum length?
600 kilometers.
Yes, it is given. It is given that the railway map which they are using to measure the distance between Delhi and Agra, in that railway map, maximum you can measure a distance of 600 kilometers. So, length of the scale is RF, which that is 1 by 40 lakh into maximum length, that is 600 kilometers. Still, you cannot solve it. Why? Because if you solve the entire expression, the final value which you will get, that you will get in kilometer. And I cannot draw a kilometer line with the help of my normal scale. Then definitely you have to convert that unit into centimeter, because I am having a scale. In that scale, centimeter option is there, then I can draw that line. So just convert it and just let me know what is the value of length of the scale, whether it is coming out to be 15 or not, 15 centimeter or not. Just calculate and let me know.
Yes, sir, it's coming 15 centimeter.
It is coming 15 centimeter. Okay. Other people, please respond whether it is correct or not. 15 centimeter.
Yes, sir, it's correct.
Okay, fine. So I got the length of the scale as 15 centimeter. So what is the next step? Now, next step is, now you have to do all these calculations by pencil, and that too in block capital letters. Okay. Next step is, I will draw a line of length 15 centimeter. I will draw a straight horizontal line of length 15 centimeter, and this 15 centimeter represent 600 kilometer. What I need to do next, I have to draw a straight horizontal line of length 15 centimeter, and this 15 centimeter, it is nothing but it is representing a distance of 600 kilometer. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Yes, so on this 600 kilometer line, which is nothing but my 15 centimeter, how many distances I have to mark? I have to mark 222 kilometer, 336, 459 and 569. If you see your normal scale, that normal scale is having some divisions. This is my normal scale. Fine. I have drawn this part. I have drawn this part. Fine. But if you see your scale, scale is having some division. 0, 1, 2, 3, say this is 4. Fine. Similarly, I am having this 15 centimeter long line. I have to divide this 15 centimeter long line into some equal number of parts to get these kind of divisions. Then only it will look like a scale. So please tell me in how many divisions I will divide this 15 centimeter line, which is equivalent to 600 kilometer, into some equal number of parts. How many parts I will divide?
4
parts. Why 4? And each, sir, okay, you told 4 parts. Each equal part will be equivalent to how many kilometers?
150
kilometer. Okay, why you are going in some difficult kind of thing? 150, then again plus 150. Go in some whole numbers, no, like 100, 200. It will be easy for us to draw.
Then we should divide it with 6 parts.
Yes,
6 equal parts.
Very good. If you see this problem, in this problem, maximum, it has been told to you that measure a distance of 569 kilometer. You have to indicate maximum a distance of 569 kilometer, and your scale will end at 600 kilometer, and this 600 kilometer line is nothing but your 15 centimeter line. So if I divide my 15 centimeter line into 6 number of equal part, each equal part is equivalent to 600 kilometer, then my problem is solved. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Yes, sir.
So by the help of set square method, if you remember in the very first or second class, I have shown you that method called set square method. With that method, we can divide any line into any equal number of parts. So with that set square method, divide this given line into six number of equal part, and each equal part is equivalent to 100 kilometer. Is it clear? Any doubt so far? Hello?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Fine. So this is my 100 plus 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 600. But if you see your normal scale, zero starts from here. Then you are getting 1 over here. Then you are getting 2 over here. Then you are getting 3 over here. But in diagonal scale, 0 starts from the second point. 0 starts from the second point. Why it is starting from the second point? That again I will tell you after 1 or 2 minutes. But you remember one thing, in your diagonal scale, 0 starts from the second division point. But in your normal scale, 0 starts from the very first division point. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. Why I have started 0 from the second division point? I think somebody's mic is unmuted. Please mute yourself. Okay. So, I have taken my 0 from the second division point. See, how many distances I have to measure? Say, if I talk about 222 kilometer, it is nothing but 200 plus 20 plus 2. So, this is my 200. This is my 200. I can easily measure 200. Next is 20. 20, where I will measure? If I divide my 100 kilometer line again into 10 number of equal part, each equal part is equivalent to 10 kilometer, then my problem is solved according to this question. Yes or no? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Again, I am repeating. Listen it very carefully. If I take 222 kilometer, I have to mark this 222 kilometer in my diagonal scale. What is 222? 200 plus 20 plus 2. 200 I can measure very easily. This is my 200. This is my zero line. This much distance is your 200 kilometer. Next comes 20. Now I cannot measure 20. How I can measure? I can measure if I divide my 100 kilometer line. This is 100 kilometer line. Again into 10 number of equal part, each equal part is equivalent to 10 kilometer, then on this 100 kilometer line, the second division point starting from this 0 will be this 20 kilometer. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Fine. So that's why in diagonal scale we start 0 from the second division point, not from the first division point. Because in this portion, I represent, this is your, say, 100th unit, this is your 10th unit, this is your single unit. So, this 10th unit, I normally measure in diagonal scale over here. So, how you can divide this 100 kilometer line again into 10 number of equal parts? Again, you have to use set square method like this. For this 15 centimeter line, this is that set square method concept. And for this 100 kilometer line, again, you have to draw this inclined line. Since you have to draw 10, you have to divide this 100 kilometer line into 10 number of equal parts. You have to cut 10 arc point on this inclined line. Then join the last arc point, then align that last arc point with your set squares. Accordingly, you will draw the parallel lines. The lines which will intersect on this horizontal line will be your those divisions like this. Is it clear? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Fine?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. So this is my 0. This will be my 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. This is my 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. This is my 100. So far we have solved 200 plus 20. See, this is my 200. This is 0, 10, 20. That means this much distance is how much? 220 kilometer. This much distance is 220 kilometer. Now this 2 is left. This 2 is left. So far, whatever we have did, this is nothing but your plane scale. So far, whatever we have did, this is nothing but your plane scale. By the help of plane scale, I can measure up till single decimal point distances. Now, since this 2 is extra, this is the second decimal point, I cannot measure by the help of this plane scale. So, I have to go for diagonal scale. So, that's why I have told you 5 minutes before that in diagonal scale can serve the purpose of plane scale, but a plane scale cannot serve the purpose of diagonal scale. Is it clear now?
Is yes, it sir.
Clear? Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
So, in order to mark that 2, I have to do again some construction. What is that construction? Okay, let me erase everything. Okay. The next step is what? You have to give certain height to the scale. If you see, the scale which you are having at present in your compass box, this is the scale. Fine, I have drawn this distance and I have marked the division point. Now I have to give some height to the scale, then only it will look like a scale. So this is that height. This is that height, and complete this rectangular box. That means this line is parallel to this line, and this line is parallel to this line. Normally, we give height 5 cm. Maximum, you will go or you will take this height as 5 cm, not more than that. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Maximum height that you can take is 5 cm. Now, you can take 4 cm, you can take 3 cm, it is up to you. Fine, but maximum height which you will take is 5 cm. Because if you draw this height as 10 cm, then it will not look like a scale. You have to make your scale to look like a scale. So, in order to make your scale to look like a scale, this height, you have to go maximum till 5 cm. Okay. So, you have drawn this rectangular box. Now, it is looking like a scale. Now, I have to measure this 2. This 2 is left. For that, what I will do? Now, you can see this height. This height you can see. Now, you have to divide this height again into 10 number of equal parts. Each equal part is equivalent to 1 kilometer. Again, I am repeating. You got 200. You got 20. Now, you need that 2. Where you will get that 2? That 2 you will get in this height, on this height. If you divide this height, that means this particular length line, into again 10 number of equal part, each equal part is equivalent to 1 kilometer, then my purpose is solved for this problem. How I can divide? Again, I have to go for inscribed circle method. That means you will draw an inclined line like this. On this inclined line, you have to cut 10 number of equal arc. That 10th arc point, you have to join with the end point of the line. Then, by the help of set square, just draw parallel lines like this. Just draw parallel lines like this. Then this will be your 0. This will be your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Likewise, this point will be your 10th point. Is it clear? Am I clear? Any doubt so far?
Yes, sir.
Koi doubt hai kisi ko? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay, that means 3 times you have to do the set square method. First for the main division, secondly for the subdivision, thirdly for the sub of subdivision. Once it is done, Next step is what? So just join these lines. From 0, draw this vertical line. From 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. And all these lines are parallel to this height line. Done? Next. Next step is, since you got these points, which points? That is this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Join all those points horizontally. And all those lines are parallel to your initial horizontal lines. So you will get this grid kind of box. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see, the name of the scale is diagonal scale. That means somewhere in this scale, I have to draw a diagonal line. Somewhere in this scale, I have to draw a diagonal line. Where I will draw that diagonal line? Already you got these points. Which point? 0. This is your 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Now this same point, the same point you can get over here also. You can get over here also. Fine. Let us mark those same points at same distances. That means this is your, say this is your 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Likewise, this is your 100. Say 70, 80, 90, 100. Is it clear? Is it clear so far? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So,
yes, sir.
Now you have to draw a diagonal line, parallel diagonal line. How you have to draw? See, this is your second point in this bottom line. This is your second point. Join this second point with this first point, like this. Similarly, just join the third, bottommost third point with the topmost second point, like this. Obviously, my lines are not parallel, but it will be parallel. If you use, in here, roller scale will help you, because only you have to align one time this line. Only you have to align one time this line with the roller scale and just move your roller scale throughout the points, you will get those parallel lines. Similarly, you have to join the fourth most bottom point with the third most top point, like this. Then the fifth most bottom point with the fourth most top point, like this. Similarly, if you do it throughout the process, lastly, you will get this, the tenth most bottom point you will be joining with the ninth most top point. Fine. So I am showing you, you please see it like this. Why I have drawn these lines again, you will get to know after 1 or 2 minutes. First, you please tell me that whether you have understood this process or not. This diagonal line process, whether you have understood or not. Hello. Have you understood this process?
Yes.
Okay. So, now my diagonal scale construction is completed. Now, I have to mark the distances on my this diagonal scale. Now see, every scale is having some unit. In the given problem, all the dimensions are in kilometer, whether it is the main dimension or it is the sub dimension or it is the sub of sub dimension. Everything is in kilometer. I know that from zero, I know that from this zero towards this side, my main scale reading is there. It is in what? It is in kilometer. So here you have to write kilometer. You write in full words, K-I-L-O-M-E-T-E-R, in block letters following the proper numbering and lettering and numbering, that concept which I have shown you in the very first class. Similarly, this is your subpart reading. It is also in kilometer, where you will show it at the extreme left, right? Kilometer, K-I-L-O-M-E-T-E-R. In this problem, all the units, whether the first decimal point, second decimal point, or the main decimal point, everything is in kilometer. In any other problem, it might differ also. Say this might be kilometer, this might be hectometer, this might be centimeter. Accordingly, you have to act. Similarly, this the second decimal point, again it is having a unit of kilometer. How I will write? See, here I have written kilometer. That means you have to write like this. K I L O, vertically you have to write M E, like this. Vertically you have to write kilometer. Okay, so once this is done, then you have to, just below this scale, write the value of RF which you have got, that is 1 by 40 lakh. And just below the RF, write, see, every drawing is incomplete without naming. So I have to give the name to this drawing. What is the name of this drawing? It is nothing but a diagonal scale showing what? It is showing kilometer. Because for the main scale reading, kilometer. For sub-scale reading also, it is kilometer. And for the second decimal point reading also, it is kilometer. So you will write diagonal scale showing kilometer. But say if it is kilometer over here, hectometer over here, centimeter over here, then how you can write? You will write diagonal scale showing kilometer, comma, hectometer, comma, centimeter. Is it clear? And that too in block capital letters. Is it clear? Any doubt so far?
No, sir, no doubts.
Okay. The last part of this problem is we have to measure these distances. Let us measure. Say I want to measure 569 kilometer. How I can measure? It is 500 plus 60 plus 9. So this is your 500. This is my 500. Now 60. 60 I will get over here. That is 0, 10, 20, 30, sorry, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. This is your 60. Fine. And along this 60, this is that diagonal line I have drawn. This is the diagonal line passing through 60. On this diagonal line, your second decimal point will lie. Remember, in diagonal scale, why we are drawing these diagonal lines? Because on these diagonal lines, my second decimal point will lie. What is the decimal point? That point is 9. So 569, that's 500, 60 plus 9. So far I have marked, this is 500, this is 60. So this distance will be 560. But I need that 9 kilometer. How I will get? That 9 kilometer will lie on this 60th diagonal line. This is your first point, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth. That means this particular point. So from here, I will just draw the extension line. Extension line. Then I will draw the arrowheads. You know how to draw the arrowheads. Just draw the arrowheads. Then you write 569 kilometer. Is it correct? Any doubt? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Similarly, we can mark the remaining distances. Okay. So, this is my 569 kilometer. Next is 459. That is 400. This is your 400. 50. This is my 50. This is my 50th line. And from that 50th line, this is that diagonal line passing through the 50th line and the 9th point. This is the 9th point. So, this is your 459 kilometer. Similarly, you can measure 336 kilometer. That means 300. This is your 300. Then 6, 336, 30. So, 0, 10, 20, 30. This is the 30. This is the 30th point. From that 30th point, this is that diagonal line passing through the 38th point. I have to go for 6th point. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. So this distance is your 336 kilometer. Similarly, you can measure 222 kilometer. Okay. I will take 3 more minutes. Jo, you can log in that meeting. But I have to, because next week you have to submit the assignment. We have completed the first assignment. So I have to tell you some instructions how you have to submit it. So please be there in the meeting for 5 more minutes. Okay. So is the problem clear to all of you? Any doubt in this problem? Hello? Any doubt in the problem? Okay. So if you are having no doubts, can anyone tell me if I want to measure 54 kilometer, how I will measure 54 kilometer? 54 kilometer. How you will measure 54 kilometer? If you have understood the concept, if you have understood,
we go to 0 to deviation.
54 means, see, this is my 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So, this is that 50th point. This is the diagonal line passing through the 58th point. Fourth point, 1, 2, 3, 4, this particular point. So, this distance will be your 54 kilometer. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So, okay. Last is, say if I want to measure 7 kilometer, how I can measure 7 kilometer? 7 kilometer, how I can measure? Hello? How I can measure 7 kilometer? See, this is my 0. This is my 0 line. This is that 0 point. This is the diagonal line passing through the 0 point. I have to find the 7th point. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th. This is the 7th point. Okay. So, this distance will be your 7 kilometer. Am I clear? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, with this, we have completed the first lab assignment. Today or by tomorrow, I will assign the lab assignment in that Google Classroom. What you need to do is, in your drawing copy or your drawing sheet, whatever you are having, you have to solve all these 5 problems. Fine. Make it a single PDF. I will give the instructions in the Google Classroom also. Make it a single PDF. And whenever you will upload it, you have to upload by your name. Your file name of the file which you will upload is your name / section / roll number, and only PDF is allowed. Do not submit those lab experiments in any other format, fine, or else it won't be checked. Okay, and remember, your deadline of submitting the lab experiment is the next week, same day is today's Wednesday, next week Wednesday. If you submit late, your experiment will be marked out of 7, not out of 10. Again, I am repeating. And regarding the use of pencils, in all the problems of first assignment, the main part of the diagram you have to draw with HB pencil. Remaining all other parts you have to draw with H and 2H pencils. That means, for example, what is the main part of this problem? The main part of this problem is your final scale. These diagonal lines, these horizontal vertical lines, and these points, 100, 0, everything. So this is the main part of your problem. This main part you have to draw with your HB pencil. Now, in order to draw this scale, 3 times you have done set square method, all those things you have to draw with H and 2H pencil. The same thing is applicable for the engineering curves part also. Cycloid, epicycloid, hypocycloid, and involute. The final curve you have to draw with HB pencil, as well as its tangent and normal. That also you have to draw with HB pencil. And in order to draw those curves, you are doing many internal constructions. Those constructions you have to do with H and 2H pencils. And remember, if in any problem calculation part is there, you have to do that calculation part by HB pencil, that too in block capital letters, maintaining the proper format, that lettering and numbering format. Am I clear? Any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay then. Thank you.
Drawings in the sketchbook.
Okay. Just wait for a minute. Okay then. Thank you. If you have any doubt, then you stay in the meeting, or else you can join the AutoCAD class. In that AutoCAD class, you will get one Google Form link. Fill that Google Form link before 4:15 p.m. After 4:15 p.m., that form will not accept any responses. So, thank you. Okay, just wait for a minute. If you are having any doubt, just wait.